Hello friend, welcome to my channel 5 Minute Pediatric. Few days back I have posted question on Facebook. The question was, what is the need of thick and thin smear in diagnosis of malaria, and which test can diagnose malaria even if the smear is negative, and who has received anti-malaria drug? So we have two ways by which we can diagnose malaria. So first we have peripheral blood smear, okay? So this is considered to be gold standard, and we have to prepare two smear, one thick one and one thin. Thick smear, which is considered to be more than 10 times more sensitive than thin smear, and it helps in detecting plasmodium, okay? And if the skilled worker or skilled microbiologist can detect even 5 to 10 parasite per microliter of blood. Next we have thin smear. It helps in detection of, that is identification of species, okay, which species actually malaria is caused, whether vivax or falciparum or malariae, okay? And it also helps in knowing whether the drug is acting or not. So you can also see the response of therapy, okay, by looking into thin smear. So now if the next question, what we have, if the smear is negative, so if you strongly suspect the person is having malaria, so at least take 3 sample before labeling it negative, okay? Next test, what we have, a rapid diagnostic test. So it is based on antigen or enzyme, okay, which is specific to genus or species of Plasmodium. So what we have Plasmodium falciparum, histidine disease protein 2, first one. Second, we have this is Plasmodium LDH and Plasmodium aldolase. These are the 3 actually antigen, or this is 2 enzyme. And this antigen, so this is for Plasmodium falciparum LDH. We have for species specific LDH, that is we have for Plasmodium falciparum and Plasmodium vivax, and we have pan single malaria LDH, okay? And the P. aldolase, this is also pan malarial antigen, okay? So it detects malaria but not a species, okay? So what we have, these two tests, okay? If the smear is negative, these two tests can be positive. So this is positive up to 28 days. Even after treatment, you can get positive up to 28 days. But these two tests become rapidly negative after treatment, but can be positive due to gametocyte. So peripheral blood smear, we have to look for response of therapy. RDT so cannot be used for monitoring response of therapy, as even after treatment it may be positive. Okay, this is all about malaria. So hope you enjoyed this video. Kindly like, subscribe and follow my channel. Thanks for watching.